We both got our we're from Gainesville, Florida. So, yeah, we've been following Spring this whole tour. It's been psychedelic.
We're really excited to share a bit with the Forest Inter community tonight. Yeah. In 2 years, 2 years ago, we did a Gainesville show in our hometown.
Song is called The Stringent Laws of Material Nature. You know, it's just about when life is kind of beating you down, when your mind is just sort of going crazy, and you don't even know why. You know, it comes and goes. That's what it's about. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, you
It's kind of like our theme song. You know, when the hero in the movie comes galloping in on his or her horse, you know, it's just a mighty song that plays. Actually, it's not like that at all. It's actually about time itself. You know, like, what the hell is this? And how is it driving us all towards our inevitable fate? You know, sometimes we, you know, like, we think about that, but sometimes we do. You know, and it's based on a verse from this text called Bhagavad Gita. Krishna, he says, time I am, destroyer of the world. I have come to destroy all people. So it's really uplifting, cheerful, loving stuff, you know.
I'm
Vedas. It's ancient text. And it tells of this great lion that descended to this planet billions of years ago to defeat the greatest demon in the history of existence. So, it's a psychedelic story. This dude, he had a special boon. This guy, his name was Hiranyakashipu. He had a boon that he could practically live forever. He did some psychedelic meditation for like 1,000 years. He stood on 1 foot, and all the insects ate all his flesh until all that was left was just his skeleton, just standing there. And so by doing this, he gained mystic powers, and he gained a special boon from Lord Brahma. Lord Brahma said, "You cannot die on land or in water, in the sky or on the ground, day or night. You cannot die by any weapon. You cannot die by animal or human." So basically, he considered himself invincible. And he ruled this world, which was known as Varsha. Back in the day, that's what the name of this place was. He ruled this world with an iron fist. He showed no mercy. He was a demon. He came from a great line of demons. And he was born a son named Prahlad. And this son, he tried to raise him like the best demon he could. He sent him to a demon like primary school. You know, like a boarding school for demons where like they teach you how to lie and cheat and steal and, you know, get your way. So, but Prahlad, he had none of this. He was empowered. He was an empowered demon. And he saw through all this shallow, superficial demon stuff. And so he said, "Father, I ain't buying into this. I ain't taking your demon crap. I'm gonna epitomize goodness and light and truth and be a beacon to the world." And his father, who was so angry, that he tried like maybe 101 different ways to kill this boy. He tried throwing him into a pit of snakes. What else? He tried drowning him. He threw him off a cliff. He had his guards take their psychedelic weapons, try and chop off his head. None of it seemed to work. He had some protection. His father could not figure it out. And one day, he said, "Prahlad, what is the source of your strength?" And Prahlad said, "Same source as yours, Father. Lord Vishnu, creator of all." And you know, this God, Hiranyakashipu, really mad. Because there's some backstory here. Lord Vishnu actually killed his brother back in the day. So it was like a feud going on. And he didn't want to take this answer at all. So where is your Lord Vishnu? Where can I find him? He's everywhere, Father. Everywhere. So then he must be in that jukebox. Or is that a cigarette machine? He must be in there. Is he? So what Hiranyakashipu did, in a fit of rage, he took his mace and he swung it at the jukebox. And out went flying a rainbow of shattered compact discs. And all the resistors and transistors, maybe there's records in there, I don't know. But it was flying into the air, shower of debris, but believe it or not, a giant lion leapt from this jukebox. And he emerged, and this lion was angry because it was none other than Lord Vishnu in the Nisringadeva form. So he was pissed. He saw how Hiranyakashipu has been messed with Prahlad, and so he started playing a game of cat and mouse with Hiranyakashipu. Run around. He even gave Hiranyakashipu the upper hand for a moment, but all was lost. He took this demon and he put him on his lap. And he was actually in a doorway. So he wasn't inside or outside. He wasn't on the ground or in the sky. And it was twilight, so it wasn't day or night. And he used his gigantic fingernails, which were no weapon known to man. And what he did was he tore these entrails, this demon out, and he wore them around his neck. So if you're ever in a Hindu temple, and you're looking at the paintings, and, you know, they're mostly, like, chill, you know, you see Krishna chilling in, like, a grove of trees, or playing with his friends, and then you see a picture of this psychedelic lion with intestines around his neck. That's what that's about. So, this next song, it's all about it, and you can follow along. Here we go.
Thank you.
sets, we have free zine. So check it out. Even if you got no money, you can come home. Take it home. Stick around.